Himachal Pradesh, and Dr. Negi has a strong interest in pursuing research in the field of cardiovascular epidemiology to gain insights into the higher prevalence of cardiovascular diseases in the state. We welcome you, sir, for chairing this session. I also invite Dr. Rajiv Raina, Professor, Department of Internal Medicine, Indira Gandhi Medical College, Shimla, and he is a popular physician who has a keen interest in research and teaching and academics along with patient care. And due to his organizational skills, he is the most sought after person for any activity in our medical college. I welcome you, sir, on this forum. And now I also would like to introduce Dr. Gopal Chauhan, who is the moderator for this session. He is Trade Program Officer, Non-Communicable Diseases, EMRT and NHM in Himachal Pradesh. And he is alumnus of our institute, and he's joined these HP Health Services in 2002. And he has been working as State Program Officer since 2007. And because of him, the state has been able to receive many awards. Especially this year, we are able to receive PM Innovation Award for NCD Prevention and Control in April 2018. And second best state in implementing NCD programs in India in October 2018. And we welcome Dr. Gopal Chauhan for this session. And I request him to be the moderator for this session.
Thank you, madam. I think this will be a wonderful session in terms of the public health approaches to non-communicable diseases, prevention and control. And we have very eminent speakers with us. We have Professor J.S. Thakur from PGI Chandigarh. And a small introduction of Professor Thakur is he's working as a professor in the School of Public Health, PGIMR Chandigarh. And he's a fellow of the Indian Public Health Association and Indian Association of Preventive and Social Medicine. He has worked as a cluster head for NCDs and mental health in WHO Country Office India for more than 3 years. And more than that, he is the founder president of World NCD Federation, which is global format for NCD prevention and control, advocacy, policy and research, as well as capacity building. And he has provided international consultancy to many developing countries, including Maldives, Sri Lanka, Timor, Liechtenstein, and many other countries also. He's a technical advisor to Haryana and Punjab, but more than that, he has been instrumental and guiding us since beginning for NCD prevention and control. It's not mentioned in his profile, but I tell you that whatever is happening in Himachal Pradesh as per NCD prevention is controlled. He is the key resource person and he is the key guide to all of us. I think without wasting much time, sir, I request Professor Thakur for his talk on national initiatives and strengthening NCD surveillance for evidence-based NCD programs, Punjab and Haryana experience. Welcome you, sir.
Very good afternoon to all of you, Professor Negi, Professor Raina, who have been esteemed teacher, and it is indeed a privilege to be here because I am also the alumni of this very great institute. And thank you, Dr. Gopal, for a very liberal introduction, which is perhaps I may not be deserving that. So I'll be discussing with you the national initiative and strengthening of NCD surveillance for evidence-based NCD program. And I will be taking the case study of Punjab and Haryana. And in this, I'll discuss about the burden, the surveillance, how we have conducted the surveillance in the two states of Punjab and Haryana, and how this has been used for building a evidence-based NCD program in these states. So if you see the burden of NCD in India, you will find that the NCDs are responsible for 62% of the total deaths occurring in the country, and 55% of the disability adjusted life years. And cardiovascular diseases are the number one killer in the urban as well as in the rural area. Another important thing about India is that, you know, the premature mortality due to non-communicable diseases. And when we say premature mortality, you know, it is the death of an individual between the age of 30 to 70 years. So there are 1/4 chances of any person dying prematurely in our country. And this is one of the very high in the Southeast Asia. Out of every 10 individuals, one has raised blood glucose, two has raised blood pressure, three use tobacco product, and two are overweight. And another problem in our country is that out-of-pocket expenditure due to non-communicable diseases. Out-of-pocket means that people have to pay from their pocket for diagnostic and treatment services is very, very high, and we are notorious in the world to have a very high out-of-pocket expenditure. Now, keeping in view of this burden, you might be aware that the National Burden of Disease Report has been released by the Honorable Vice President of India. And India is facing now epidemiological transition. And out of these total states, 5 states are having very high epidemiological transition. And 2 of them are in North India. One is Punjab, another is Himachal Pradesh. And 3 are the southern states. So the burden of non-communicable diseases is very high in Himachal Pradesh as well. Now coming to some of the milestones that what happened over a period of time, the NCD program start building from the global strategy for prevention and control of non-communicable diseases, which came into being in 2008, and then it was revised again from 2008 to 2013. And the third strategy is now going from 2013 to 2020. This FCTC came into being, and India was among the first 10 countries in the world to, you know, sign the FCTC, and Tobacco Act was enacted. So you can see all these red things are happening in India. Then NPCDCS program was, that is the National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Disease, Stroke, was launched in 2010. And now this program is covering almost whole of the country. Then we have, you know, a national summit in New Delhi, that is the National NCD Summit, which was organized by the WHO and the ministry. I was that time working in the WHO country office for India. And we came up with the New Delhi Call for Action, which is published in Indian Journal of Community Medicine. Then we have a national monitoring framework where there are 10 targets and 21 indicators. I will be discussing a little detail. Then there was a national consultation for multi-sectoral action plan in this very city. And now this plan will be taken up in the next session. Then we have, you know, other few milestones which are not shown here, that last year there was the UN high level meeting, which was second on non-communicable diseases. And we also organized a World NCD Congress in 2017. And we also came up with the Chandigarh Call for Action on Non-Communicable Diseases. And mean the time, this Sustainable Development Agenda was also introduced in the world from 2015 onward. And we have to achieve these 17 goals by 2030. Coming a little bit to the national monitoring framework on NCD, and we have 10 targets to be achieved by 2025, right? And one of the important target is that we want to achieve 25% relative reduction in premature mortality due to non-communicable diseases. There are other indicators as well, but this will be only possible if we are, you know, we are very focused. So there are some of the indicators related to the burden, there are some of them are related to the risk factors, and some of them are related to the health system. Now coming to the NPCDCS program, which I mentioned, This was launched in 2010, and these are the key strategies under the program, that is the capacity building, prevention, screening and early diagnosis, case management, supervision, monitoring and evaluation. And now by the end of 2018, almost whole of the country is covered under the program. We have now another big initiative, which is Ayushman Bharat, and you all are aware that there are two main components under this. National Health Protection Scheme to provide cashless treatment to the patient, catering to mainly secondary and tertiary care, and there is a health and wellness center provision to provide primary health care to the patients. Now, there are around 150,000 sub-centers in the country, and they will be upscaled to the or strengthened to be health and wellness center in the country. And from here, we need to strengthen these centers to provide with the additional manpower by mid-level professional, which could be a nurse, and some of the states they have decided it to be the Ayurvedic graduates, and they will be providing the services in the 12 components of health and wellness center. And out of these 12 components, one component is pertaining to screening and management of non-communicable diseases. Now, one thing which is very important about non-communicable diseases, that 80% of your type 2 diabetes, stroke, they are, and some of the cardiovascular diseases, they are preventable. 30 to 40% of our cancers are preventable, but India, 70% of the cancers are preventable, because major chunk come from the smoking and smokeless form of tobacco. But if you see really, you know, the health and wellness will come only if you are focusing on the setting based approaches for health promotion, and first and foremost is health promoting schools. We say in non-communicable diseases, catch them young, because all your good and bad habits are formed in your childhood. And then health promoting workplaces. We are very notorious in the world to have very high risk profile workplaces. If you see the risk profile of our workplaces by the study done by us and the Confederation of Indian Industry, you will find that the prevalence of stress in workplaces is to the extent of 45%. Diabetes and hypertension, 40 to 45%. Why it is so? Some of our supervisors, they are very much interested to creating stressful environments. So we are living in stressful conditions and risky workplaces, and that focus has also been, of course, health promoting communities. But do you find all this focus in your health and wellness center, which has the 12 component which has been proposed? This is a big question mark. Are we talking about health promoting school, health promoting workplaces, health promoting school in so-called health and wellness center which we are proposing? There is a lack of focus, and if we really want to have healthier communities, then we have to focus on these components. And there are many things which are available. We have a 12 to 20 weeks lifestyle intervention among school children. We have an accreditation program for health promoting schools. We have model for healthy workplaces for NPCDCS, and we have also recently developed a health promoting district model under the funding from ICMR. So such models are available, but we really want to, we should incorporate this in the overall health and wellness concept if we really. Now coming to the NCD surveillance, you know, in NCD as per WHO, there are three pillars which need to be focused. One is that those who are healthy, they should remain healthy. And that is the health promotion. Those, we should know what is the risk profile of our population, that will come from the surveillance. And those who are suffering from the disease, they should get the treatment by having access to the diagnostic and the essential. Now I am focusing on the surveillance part in this. So you will find that robust and sustainable system is still lacking in our country. And it is very important that we should know what is the risk profile of Himachal Pradesh. If we have to see what is the impact of the program which Dr. Gopal is implementing in state in next 5 years, it will come if we know that what is the baseline risk profile of our population. Multi-state representative national wide step surveys under process, but only 7 states they could complete the IDSP NCD risk factor survey in the country in 2007 and 8, and after that there was no sign from moving from, you know, survey to surveillance. So this is how we decided that let us come up with the state models, and I'll be sharing some finding of our state model which we took step surveys in the state of Punjab and Haryana, and the objective was to determine the prevalence of the risk factor, to prepare the baseline data for the risk factor, and to assess the economic burden of non-communicable diseases. Step surveys, we call them step because they are done in the 3 steps. The first step is questionnaire based, where we assess the behavioral risk factor. Step 2 is the physical measurement, where you take height, weight, BMI, blood pressure measurement to see that what are the physical dimension, overweight, obesity. And step 3 is the biochemical investigation, which include sugar, lipid profile, and many other things if we are interested. Now coming to the steps, key features of the Punjab and Haryana step survey, the PGI was the coordinating center. 4 medical colleges in the state of Punjab and 5 medical colleges in the state of Haryana were involved, and the sample size was around 5,500. 100 PSU, your primary sampling unit, were taken in Punjab and 150 primary sampling unit in Haryana, and the age group was 18 to 69 years. It was done under the funding under the National Health Mission as an operational research project, and these surveys are also led to the involvement of the local medical colleges so that they can conduct in future. We also developed the local technology, that is the mobile-based app for doing these paperless survey, and it was a low-cost strategy. The survey was done in 2 days period. The first day was the questionnaire administering, and second was the physical measurement, which was done on the first day, and in the second day, the blood samples were taken, so 2 day exercise in any village. We also developed a mobile-based app. You know, the step survey are done by the personal digital assistants. These were called e-steps, but that time, because these are taken on loan from the WHO and they were not available during that time, then we decided to develop our own technology with the help of IIT Mumbai. And we developed a mobile app, and the beauty of this mobile app was that any Android phone can be used for data collection. Data will come to the PGI, you can download the data and can analyze. We developed it in Punjab state, and eventually the Haryana was totally paperless survey, and in Haryana some of the further innovations were that the web support for monitoring the progress. That, and also we also try to incorporate the GIS system to see the location of the worker in the district, and this is how a website was also created. Now coming to the key output of this survey, we have published the fact sheet, the reports, and the surveillance manual for these states, and the surveillance manual is vetted at the international level. Then technology innovation M steps I have already shared. We have published 7 papers in international journals from Punjab and 1 from Haryana as of now. And this is the, you know, figure which is showing the risk profile of the population of Punjab and Haryana. You can see less than 5 servings of fruits and vegetables is taken by almost 95% of the population. Despite the fact that Punjab and Haryana are agriculture state, they are producing the vegetable for Himachal Pradesh and adjoining states. We were really surprised to have this sort of finding. We did some, you know, the qualitative research and found that people are not eating fruits and vegetables. Any reason in the audience? The farmer said they you are using lot of pesticides and these vegetables are not fit for consumption. Those who were consuming, they were producing it in an organic way. And then raised salt intake, you can find that it was very high in these both states. High blood pressure, the prevalence of high blood pressure is 40% in Punjab and 26% in Haryana. Low physical activity, one third people were having low physical activity as compared to 16%. And you will find that if you see overweight and obesity, 40% of the people in Punjab are either overweight and obese if we take BMI less than, more than 25. And if we use the Asian cutoff of 23, then 58% of the Punjabis were either overweight or obese, right? So we are basically having an epidemic of obesity, and you can see this figure for even Haryana also, which was almost 35%. Another important thing which we did in Punjab was this albumin creatinine ratio in the urine. And this was very high, 43% and 24% albumin creatinine ratio. It means that people were at the risk of what? Kidney diseases. We also did healthcare cost in the state, and out-of-pocket expenditure was very high. So 80% of the people in Punjab, they were paying for diagnostic. There is 25% and 55% was either for diagnostic or for treatment. And you can see it was almost 57% for Haryana. So on an average, a Punjabi spend around 2,000 rupees for outpatient treatment and 11,000 rupees for inpatient, which is very, very high. Now, this is a very important diagram which we need to see. Sometimes we call hypertension and diabetes as a silent killer, right? And we also know that there is a rule of half, right? But let us see what is there in the state of these. So prevalence of hypertension is 40% in Punjab and 26% in Haryana. Out of these, what proportion is aware about their hypertension status? Only 48% in Punjab and 23, one-third in Haryana. Out of these, only 26 to 30% are on treatment and 12 to 18% are controlled. But 70 to 73% are untreated. So this is the state of affair in the progressive state like Punjab and Haryana. Let us see about the diabetes. The prevalence of diabetes is 14 to 15%. Only one third are aware that they are suffering from diabetes. Only around one fourth are taking treatment, and only 13 to 14% are controlled. So we have around 71 to 77% of the people which are untreated. What does it shows? That our program perhaps is not able to reach to the grassroots level, and people are not taking treatment, or this could be possible maybe due to the high out-of-pocket expenditure due to diagnostic and essential medicine, because access to medicine is not available. Now, how we use these data for the benefit of the National NCD program, these state, we have a state level action plan for these states for the program now. And key initiative for health system, Punjab has started the cervical cancer screening program now in all their centers, but specifically in two blocks in a very systematic way. Otherwise, under the program, they are doing it. And also recently launched HPV vaccination for adolescent girl, which made it the first state in the country to do so, because cervical cancer is still the number one cancer in rural Punjab. Then pertaining to the program and clinical interventions, the provision, the Punjab has 232 drugs under the essential drug list. Out of them, very few were for non-communicable disease. That was revised, and access and availability of drugs was ensured. Keeping in view of high overweight and obesity, we recommended that they should be setting up the obesity management and detection services in their clinic. For healthcare course, they initiated this Bhagat Puran Singh Sehat Bima Yojana, right? And this is now merged with the National Ayushman Bharat scheme. And we also recommended integration and convergence with all other national health programs. This survey also gave us two states the 12 indicators out of the 21 indicators. So these were the benefits for the program, and state decided to focus on health promotion, and they also agreed that they will be repeating this surveillance in the next 5 years, and they also tried to strengthen the treatment services by having access to the medicines. Now, one of the problem in medicine is that under the program, the medicine should be given for 3 months, but some of the states, they have decided for 1 month. But if you go to the clinic, nobody gives it for more than 5 days, and patient are eating for 5 days, and eventually they are leaving. And so compliance to the treatment is one of the major issue. So just to summarize, this is my last present slide, that key initiative have started, but there are many implementation challenges in NCD program. The statewide NCD step survey, they have contributed significantly in state-specific action plans and evidence-based program. This surveillance program is integrated with the National Health Mission. It led to the capacity building, low-cost technology innovations, and it also motivated the other states, because we shared our M-STEP app with the Kerala state also, and now Kerala has also completed. And Haryana has also constituted a task force. And some of these activities are done under the aegis of World NCD Federation, which Dr. Gopal also mentioned, a professional association working for public health approaches that is strengthening health promotion, surveillance, and disease management. We publish a book on public health approaches to non-communicable disease. We publish International Journal of Non-Communicable Diseases. We have health promotion manual in 3 languages, and we also organized international NCD course and CME. The last one was only 2 days back, which we finished 5th international course, which is a PGI AIMS collaboration. And we are also coming up with the guidelines for NCD for primary and secondary healthcare setting. You can visit the website. There is also a stall which is available for more information. And this is what I wanted to share with you. Thank you very much.
Are we taking questions thank you very much, sir, for your detailed presentation. And I think now we are clear that what surveillance means and what are the importance of surveillance. With the permission of chair, I request that the question should be taken at the end, sir, as you suggest. I would like to invite our next speaker, Dr. Anand Krishnan from AIIMS. Brief introduction of Dr. Anand Krishnan. Dr. Anand Krishnan has been working in AIIMS as a faculty since 1994. He has spent more than 15 years as a faculty in its rural field practice area, Ballabgarh, which has been responsible for many initiatives, including the use of digital solution for healthcare. And he's having a very, you know, big list of his academic achievements. And mainly, I would like to point out few of his achievements as a national advisory or expert group. He's the member of the governing body, National Health System Resource Center, NHRC, New Delhi, and task force to develop operational guidelines for strengthening RMNCHA, which is other than NPCDCS or NCD. Technical Advisory Group for NCDs and CPSC Healthcare Package, and ICMR Project Review Committee for NCD Division, CBD Mental Health and Neurology. More than that, he has been guiding the Government of India policy since beginning, and I am thankful to Dr. Anand Krishnan to be here, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Chauhan. There will be some overlap between what Dr. Thakur presented, so that I will skip some of my slides in order to maintain the time. But my focus would be on multi-sectoral action plan. We all know, recognize that NCDs are a multi-sectoral issue. It is not only the health ministry, we should be dealing with NCDs. And therefore, we should respond to it multi-sectorally. So my focus will be on telling you what is happening in India. So at national level on surveillance, more on multi-sectoral action plan. India developed a multi-sectoral action plan, and this is the document. I don't think this is officially out yet. It is awaiting formal release by the minister, I think. But the plan is there. The plan was developed long time back. The necessary 2013-14, we had a lot of regional consultations in all the four regions of the country, based on which we formed a team which had myself, representatives from ICMR, MHFW, and WHO, who drafted this multi-sectoral action plan. It then went through a process of review, both internal as well as it was shared with all the ministries in the Government of India. They all provided a feedback on this, and then it was finalized last year after receiving feedback from all the ministries. So this is an action plan which has been at least seen by all the ministries, and everybody has vetted. The vision of this plan says that all Indians enjoy the highest attainable status of health and well-being and quality of life at all ages, free of preventable NCDs and premature deaths. We all know that not all NCDs are preventable, nor are all deaths preventable due to NCDs preventable. So we are focusing on preventable NCDs and premature deaths by promoting healthy choices, reducing preventable morbidity, avoidable disability, which means rehabilitation, and premature mortality. It has five objectives. I'm not going to read all of them, but you can see the first objective is to increase resource allocation for NCDs, advocate for that. Second is to strengthen multi-sectoral partnership. Third is on health promotion by making healthier choices by creating healthy environment, because we all make choices based on the environment where we live. Our choices are not really free. The next one is, as Dr. Thakur said, to provide accessible and affordable good quality care, access to essential medicines and technologies. And finally, a sustainable surveillance, monitoring, and evaluation systems. So with this objective, there are four broad pillars. All the actions are listed under four broad pillars: multi-sectoral action, health promotion, health system strengthening, monitoring, and evaluation. With all ministries participating, with cooperation from private sector and civil society partners. So you can see that this is the system that has been proposed under this plan, that there will be a committee of secretaries of all relevant ministries, which will be chaired by a cabinet secretary. And then you have an interministerial committee, which will be chaired by a secretary, health and family welfare, where generally joint secretaries of other ministries will come. And then you will also have a health promotion mechanism. There will be technical advisory groups. The NCD cell, central NCD division in the directorate, is the focal point for all activities. And obviously, this is a state subject. Therefore, state governments will be an important player in this whole this thing. And this will be the partners, UN partners, civil society, private sector, and other stakeholders. So this is the mechanism for implementation which has been formulated in this action plan. So again, set four, health promotion. We are still not sure. There were a lot of discussion in the ministry on whether we should set up a separate mechanism for health promotion. In the original plan for this, it was Health Promotion Foundation of India was proposed, that we should establish a separate agency for health promotion. So there is still some discussion, but no clarity whether we should institute a separate health promotion agency for promoting health in India. That call is yet to be taken, but otherwise, this is being monitoring and evaluation is led by ICMR. So that's the focal agency for surveillance monitoring. Health system strengthening, obviously, the Directorate General. And multi-sectoral action plan is the three tiered committees which you just saw. So how much have we progressed in this action plan? 34 ministries have set up a nodal officer. So each ministry was asked to identify one person in that ministry, maybe a director or a joint secretary level person who would be coordinating NCD activities with the health ministry. So that has been done in most ministries. There is already a technical advisory group set up on air pollution, tobacco, alcohol, and high fat and salt sugar containing foods. Committee of secretaries has met once. The role of all ministries has been defined and accepted by the ministries. And we have recently started a training of state and district program managers of NPCDCS to how to work with other sectors. So some amount of capacity building in the health ministry of both states and central is happening through this program manager training, which was developed by my team from AIIMS, along with WHO and Ministry of Health. But there are still many challenges. NCDs are still perceived as a health ministry issue, even though you have some people set up as a nodal officer, but whether how much of their interaction occurs and how much do they really own the actions related to NCDs is still to be decided. We have a lot of NCD programs and verticalization program, and Dr. Chauhan says this is the focus of his presentation, how to integrate programs. MCH and CD still is a priority resource allocation. Only 3% of health ministry budget goes to NCDs, even now. Even though Dr. Thakur said 62% of deaths occur by NCDs, only 3% of NCD the resources budget of health ministry goes to NCD program. We know that the role of private sector is huge in healthcare provision as well as in the industrial part of it. But we have still not managed to put in place mechanisms by which we can work with private sector on to address many of the commercial determinants of health, which are basically marketing of various products which influence our health choices and rather adversely. So we still need to have a big debate on how to address private sector and how to address commercial determinants of health. These are perhaps two big elephants sitting in our room which we are not addressing at all at this stage. Briefly on some of these has already been told by Dr. Thakur that India has 21 indicators. Globally, they have taken 25 indicators. We have deleted some of them, including for cervical HPV vaccination, trans fats, etc. And we have added one, which is on the indoor air pollution. And the harmful use of alcohol, while the global is on harmful use, the Indian indicator is on use of alcohol. The harmful is not a part of Indian this thing. So these are the 21 indicators which cover different aspects of NCD, including one on palliative care, as you can see, though not much activity is occurring in palliative care in India, except in Kerala. So if you have to answer those indicators, we need information from multiple sources. I will not take you through all of them. But obviously, for risk factors, we have to do a national NCD risk factor survey. I will briefly cover it in my next slide. For mortality, we have the sample registration-based systems. For health facility, we really do not have a good health facility survey, but again, we have attempted this recently. And for disease registries, we have cancer registry and diabetes surveys currently occurring across the country. So what are the issues in national NCD surveillance? We still have very ad hoc and fractured surveillance systems. We have separate tobacco surveys, alcohol surveys, nutrition surveys, largely in a very huge sample size. For example, GATS took 1 lakh people across the country. So we are doing huge surveys for just one risk factors, whereas we should do an integrated survey at such a large survey, which would provide information on all the risk factors, and we will save a lot of money. There used to be a health facility survey as a part of DLHS, but now that DLHS has been scrapped and merged with NFHS, this has been dropped. So right now we have no national levels source for health facility. Again, it need not be, currently even in DLHS it was done only for RCH. You could easily add an NCD component and do a health facility survey, which is across programs, not program specific. IDSP is the main framework or umbrella under which all surveillance occurs, but this does not adequately cover NCDs. Therefore, we have almost a parallel system which is occurring as a part of NCD surveillance. Again, that is not very desirable thing to have. We need to see how we integrate with IDSP better. We already discussed that health is a state subject and state should be promoted. And as Dr. Thakur presented, Haryana, Punjab, and Kerala have done subnational surveys. Other states, especially Northeast, are showing interest, and hopefully we'll have more state-level surveys, which would be, in a way, mentored by either AIIMS team or by the PGI team. So almost all the surveys in the country would be mentored by the AIIMS team or a PGI team. So that's and we gradually build capacity that states can then in future work on it by themselves. There are a lot of turf wars which we keep discussing, but if you especially want a multi-sectoral action, we need to have a good leadership which takes care of all these things. all the indicators that we showed 2010 as a baseline. But we didn't do any survey in 2010. So actually, we have no baseline to compare our gains. Therefore, ICMR was entrusted with the responsibility to conduct a meta-analysis and come arrive at estimates for 2010, which we have recently completed, and we'll be finalizing in next week. Dr. J.P. Narayan, who is here, he is the chairperson of that committee, as well, along with the NCD risk factor survey. So both of them are in near or about to be completed, and you would be getting national level data very soon, within a month or so, hopefully. So this is the only risk factor for which we have a good baseline, because GATS1 occurred in 2009, and GATS2, which occurred in 2016, clearly shows that the tobacco is declining. Our target is 30% by 2025. So the decline seems to be on in the correct path to achieve that target, though smokeless tobacco obviously is a bigger cause of concern than smoked tobacco. There have been some key national initiatives which has been occurring: health system strengthening, the comprehensive primary health care and population-based screening, which has been started across the country. There is also, we are developing a software by which the CBAC, which is a checklist which ASHA will fill, will get entered into a handheld with an A&M. And then all patients can be traced from that point onwards till whatever treatment they are, till district level. So this software is being developed by Dell, and it has already been implemented till primary health center level, but up to CHC and district, they are in the process of finalizing. So hopefully in this year, we'll have a data set of all patients who are registered under this program, right from their blood sugar, what is their control. So you need a cohort of patients to see how many are treated, how many are controlled. That we should be available to us, a cohort of all patients in the government sector, by end of this year. And NPCTS program is increasing its coverage in many parts of this. Though as we see in our national survey also, this is still not up to the desired mark. We have just completed national NCD monitoring survey, including health facility. State level survey we have discussed. SRS-based mortality surveillance, again, AIIMS New Delhi is now leading the mortality surveillance SRS-based in the country. And you have a stall on Minerva in the conference. You can see that. And there has been a dramatic expansion of cancer registries in India, both which are ICMR-led as well as by Tata Memorial Cancer. So now we have almost 30-40 cancer registries in India. And we have excellent data on cancer incidence and cancer outcomes, which is quite easily, now we can say, nationally representative. Health promotion, as we all know, is always the weakest part of a chain in our link. We have still not, as I said, not set up a nodal agency. Even though health and wellness centers have a primary responsibility of health promotion, it is still not very well defined. What is exactly going to be done in them to promote health is still not, we are not sure. Those modules are being written up, and hopefully they will really scale up our health promotion activities in near future. So in conclusion, while there is a gradual increasing recognition that NCDs are important in India, it is still not getting its due share of resource allocation. A lot of new initiatives are occurring at national level, at state level. So a lot of dynamism is being seen in the way we are addressing NCDs, but they are not yet scaled up of magnitude that is required for a country of India's size. So even though some initial results are being seen, we are still way far behind in giving a good multi-sectoral comprehensive response to NCDs in the country. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I think we are very, very, very clear, and we can think that, you know, what next need to be done. First, we learned about the surveillance part, then, you know, the multi-sectoral action plan. With the permission of the chair, now, sir, it's my presentation, and I will be talking, you know, that how to implement these programs at field level. Uh, Sir, I will be talking about the initiatives which the state government has taken recently. And it's not fair to talk after such eminent speakers, but I am daring to do so. Sir, pardon me for that. And what Himachal model we are trying to develop, I will be sharing that with you. We are trying to do something for prevention and control of non-communicable diseases through a state initiative, which is popularly known as Mukhyamantri Nirog Yojana in Himachal Pradesh. The scheme has been budgeted in the last budget by the state government, and now we are in a process to scale it. This is, you know, I think that you are very clear that the prevention part is very, very important. Maybe economic gains and other, you know, health related outcomes. Diagnosis of life-threatening diseases at early stages is very, very important, and we count them in the preventive part. I will be talking about brief about Himachal Pradesh and about the continuum of care, gaps in the existing policies, specifically to Himachal Pradesh, Nirog Yojana, risk factors, specifically about Himachal Pradesh and status of the program, what is happening. You all know about the profile of Himachal Pradesh, but the best part is that the infant mortality is decreasing. It has come down from 34 to 25, but still we are at the 20th place in the country as far as the SRS data is concerned. The best part is that more than 60 to 70% people are still believing in healthcare facilities in the public sector, which is unique in India. You see, in comparison with Kerala, only 20 to 25% people are going for healthcare services to the government setup. Continuum of care, you are all from academic background. It is, you know, to take care, to see the activities, to see the changes as a life cycle approach since birth to death. And whatever is happening in between, we have to take in account everything for that. Whatever policies we do have, as far as the NCD prevention and control is concerned, if we think of the continuum of care approach, what we see that up to 18 years we have a program. I am not talking about that what level of, you know, what percentage of the components are being implemented in the state as well as in the country. But we have something to offer to the people, to the children up to the age of 18 years through RBSK program. Second, for more than 30 year people, we have the NPCDCS program. But you know that majority of the risk factors, maybe alcohol, maybe tobacco use, maybe unhealthy diet, it is initiated in the 18 to 30 age group. And if we don't address this age group, if we don't address those risk factors in this age group, it means we need to land in a situation where we have to treat patients, which were easily preventable, the diseases were preventable, we could do something for prevention part, but if you are not taking care of this age group, it means that they have to land in some diagnostic center, they may have to land in some, you know, dialysis center, they have to go to some cancer physician for treating their cancers. What about the Mukhyamantri Nirog Yojana? We are doing a life cycle approach. We are also covering the 18 to 30 year age group for the annual screening and their health checkup. This is the key mandate of the Nirog Yojana, and the RBSK program will be strengthened. And as Professor Thakur suggested, that we should have a health promotion model, that health promoting what we call a healthy workplace, what we call a healthy school. We are also working on that. As far as the state is concerned, I am working in the NCD division since 2009, but I was told that Himachal is very healthy. We walk a lot, we do a lot of work in our fields, and we are, you know, very good as far as our dietary habits are concerned. But I was surprised by seeing this report, which is released last year by ICMR and Government of India. You know that we have a higher risk, we have a higher mortality. It means that we should not say, we should not emphasize that we are a healthy state. We are not a healthy state as far as the NCDs are concerned, as far as the risk factors are concerned. We should not feel proud that Himachal are very good in their health. You know, you can see whatever the major risk factor, you can, you know, elaborate more, you can study the report in detail, but you know, it is a major concern that the NCDs are to be tackled in the state of Himachal Pradesh on a priority basis. What is the challenge? The challenge is we are trying to treat few patients, but we are not, you know, trying to turn off this tap. The people are not able to understand what I think that we are not able to understand about non-communicable diseases. We think that, okay, it's going on, chalta hai sab. Diabetes ki dawaiyan de do, hypertension ki dawaiyan de do, what about the risk factors? Until unless the risk factors are remaining there, the NCD prevention and control, we cannot think. We cannot, simply say that by treating patients, you know, we can end up saying that we are a healthy state, the risk factors have come down. There is a demand and supply of those risk factors. You see, where in Shimla, where will you find a healthy food? I have been part of this medical college. We used to eat paranta for months together in Auntie Dhaba in Sunjoli. And what about talking of the healthy food, fruits and vegetables? This is the scenario as far as this medical college is concerned. I find that we are trying to do a survey here, sir. We are, as of now, we are focusing on HP Sector and HP University to develop at a model healthy place. But the survey has to be done in this medical college. Then we will come to realize that what kind of doctors we are producing here and what was their life profile in those 5 or 6 years when they were student in the medical college. It may have changed now, but I talk in my days from 95 to 2000 in this medical college. But we have a poor understanding of public health approaches for NCD prevention and control. As a doctor, I am trained, you know, ki diabetes, agar koi patient ka ye level aata hai, to treat him with this medicine. Whatever may be the mistake, but we put on patient on treatment. Uske baad hum kehte hain ki you come for follow-up after a few days. But, you know, we never say to the people that, you know, we have to take care of those risk factors also. But now, this is the time to realize. And I am thankful to the organizer to organize this session in this very important conference so that people can understand that, you know, what and how we can control the risk factors. The achievements of Himachal Pradesh, we are the highest, we are in the top in the country as far as the screening part is concerned. We have screened around about 29% of the eligible population in the state for diabetes and hypertension. In the rest of the India, the average is only 5 to 6%. And we have established the cardiac care units in 11 out of 12 districts. They may not be functioning well, but as of now, the infrastructure is there. We have started daycare centers, those where we are providing the chemotherapy services. They are not oncologists, they are simply MBBS graduates. They have been trained in Asian Institute of Cancer, Research Institute Mumbai and Ujjain, and they are giving follow-up chemotherapies. And till date, more than 1,600 follow-up chemotherapy has been given at district and sub-district level hospitals by those MBBS doctors. And 3 years back, we were having only 2 dialysis centers in the state. As on today, we have 13 functional dialysis units and more than 45,000 dialysis sessions has been conducted in those dialysis centers. And we have a unique project, which is a telestroke project. It may not be functioning well, but as of now, we can say that we have thrombolyzed more than 330 patients in district and sub-district level hospital, including medical colleges. The biggest achievement of my state, which I am trying to emphasize, is the reduction in tobacco use by 24%. As per the GAS data is concerned, in 2009, the prevalence of tobacco use was 21.2%. It has come down to 16.1%, and I am thankful to all the stakeholders, those who are involved in prevention and control of tobacco. We have been able to impose a cess on alcohol, because you know that public health advocate used to say that we have to levy high tax on these unhealthy products like alcohol, unhealthy food, and tobacco. And I'm looking after the emergency response system of 108 ambulances. We used to spend 30 crore rupees for that services. And majority of the patients which are being transported, they are, you know, when we analyze, wo sharab pi karke gaadi chalate hain, unka accident hota hai. And we have been, you know, collecting 8 crore rupees as it says from, you know, it is 1 rupee per bottle. I'm not saying that you should consume more alcohol to collect this money, but I say that we are collecting 8 crore rupees from this cess. And Dr. Anand Krishnan was saying that we are, you know, very poor in palliative care services. Sir, I would like to tell you, We have trained three doctors last year from Pelium India Trivendram in palliative care. Unfortunately, and by virtue of their good luck and intelligence, they got selected in medical colleges for PG. Now only one is left with us. And this year we have trained more 11 doctors from Pelium India. And till by 31st of this month, we will be having 11 palliative care units in the state, which will be in the district level and few big civil hospitals. Yes, the biggest component in the NCD program is the respiratory disease component. But we are lucky that in this PIP, we have got approval from the Government of India to establish respiratory disease, you know, prevention and control units at district level on the analogy of cancer care units. This is what we have done in the state. And most important, we are doing the electronic surveillance of non-communicable diseases and risk factors in the state. We have developed an app. The app is on the analogy of the Government of India app. But the Government of India is covering only three diseases. We are covering 10 diseases in that app. Government of India is covering three or four risk factors. We are covering 15 risk factors in that app. And till date, I have been given the list just now. We are the second highest in the country for the enrollment of the people. Only Tamil Nadu is ahead of us. We have enrolled 4 lakh people. Tamil Nadu has enrolled 5 lakh people in the NCD application. Sir, this is the risk profile of the state. This is the surveillance which we are doing on a routine basis. This is the data being collected by the ASHA worker. Now we can see that from these 4 lakh people, 16.8% are tobacco users. But the GATT survey says that it is 16.1%. It means that our information is relatively, you know, in comparison with the Government of India data as well as the survey is concerned. This is the risk profile of the population. Now, this is the screening done by health worker as far as the measurement of the blood pressure, measurement of the, you know, blood sugar is concerned. I am not going on the quality because when you roll out the program in the field, you have to compromise quality up to large extent. But I tell you, once you roll out the program, the quality can be, you know, ensured in later stages. And I think that in next 3 to 4 years, we will be focusing more on the quality issue. This is the breakup of the diseases. As per as the data enrollment by the health workers is concerned, what we are doing, the ASHA worker is going house to house for enrollment of the people. As far as the Government of India program is concerned, they only tell that only 30 plus population has to be enrolled, but we are enrolling the 18 plus population. And then the patients are going to the A&M, few are referred to the doctors, those who are having the high blood pressure and blood sugar. This is the confirmation of the diagnosis. 5170 patients has reached to the doctors. This is the percentage of the disease. This is not incident and prevalence. And 1,200 patients has been put on treatment by the doctor. I have the data, how many are taking drugs, how many are lost to follow-up, and how many are dying. I can show this data. I am giving the answer to the assembly from this application and to the Government of India also. This is, you know, the screening output. We can analyze the data at state level, that what is happening. And luckily, we have got the PM Innovation Award last year on 21st of April for this innovation, for this Digital India Initiative for e-surveillance of NCDs. And we got the second best award in the Kaziranga Best Practices Meet. I would like to share with you that in 2016, we were the worst performer in India as far as the NCD prevention control program is concerned. Thanks to Professor Thakur, Dr. P.C. Negi, the entire medical college team. We hold, I think, 5 repeated multiple stakeholder meeting by involving, I think, most of the head of Department of Medical College Shimla, from PGI Chandigarh, from AIIMS, and from WHO, and now we are able to roll out this NCD program successfully in the country. Recently, we were called for display in the Digital Global Health Summit exhibition in New Delhi. We were selected, our electronic health card was, you know, selected for exhibition in the Global Health Digital Summit. The operational plan, I have already told you that what is our key mandate. The mandate is addressing the key risk factor, because I tell you, if you tell to someone that you have a high blood sugar, take it as a guaranteed that he will not consume more sugar now. he may lend to the doctor. Our emphasis should be that he should go to the doctor. But you tell him that you are having a high blood pressure, he may, then he is likely to consume low amount of salt and low sugar intake. This is what we expect, and we think that by 2022, we will be enrolling the entire population of 18 plus in that NCD application, and we are committed to reduce the NCD burden as far as the SDG commitments are concerned. But I tell you, until unless we address the risk factors, we are not going to achieve this SDG target by 2050 even. Monitoring is being done electronically, and I think that the health promotion through awareness and enforcement is very, very important, because doctors cannot impose fine on tobacco user or a tobacco seller or a alcohol unauthorized seller of alcohol and unhealthy diet. We can only do the advocacy. It is a multi-stakeholder game, and legislation part is very, very important. And simultaneously, we need to strengthen the existing health system. That's all from my side. Thank you very much.
Components which are important in the prevention and control of NCD, as has been already emphasized, NCDs are the leading causes of disease burden, premature deaths. So as a cardiologist, practicing cardiologist with some exposure in the public health and few studies which we have also done, we find in Himachal the level of awareness is not that bad as has been projected in the Punjab and Haryana. We did in one tribal district in Kinnaur district, and we found that level of awareness about the hypertension was around 60%. In fact, diabetes was much higher. And the percentage of patients on treatment was also reasonably quite high. So control rate was not that good. In fact, the diabetes control rate is worse. Hypertension is relatively better. So it is definitely important. If you have to control NCDs in the community, we need an empowered community through health promotion. You need a public health intervention. I think we have the existing healthcare infrastructure. We have the frontline health workers, which are least utilized. For example, the health educators, health supervisors, and these the health workers. So I think in the comprehensive approach to the prevention and control of cardiovascular disease, they need to be part and parcel of this campaign of prevention and control of NCDs. And I think the Dr. Chauhan, which has emphasized very ambitious screening program, I think this is what it is required. I was just thinking before this, we could have some sustainable surveillance system by training the health worker in the sub-center level. And in order to ensure the annual, survey of the community sustainably without additional funding, not being on the project mode, we can have that kind of surveillance system, active population-based surveillance system, by training the health worker and ask each health worker to randomly screen maybe 20, which is easier. So I think random sampling method, if you survey in a small percentage of patients, probably the quality of data which you are going to collect is much better rather than enlarge this thing. And in Himachal, if you see the total number of how many subcenters are there, each subcenter suppose contribute 20 people, at least we have a reasonable, reliable figure of the state-specific, what are the prevalence of the NCD risk factors. And the most important, Dr. Anand also spoke, is the multisectorial, I think, which is least explored. This requires a policy intervention. Health is not only the domain of the health department. I think you need an enabling environment, which you have highlighted. If you have no choices to make a healthy food, for example, you go to any restaurant in Mall Road, you will not find any healthy food. So people are forced to basically take unhealthy food. We have no choices for exercises. So there is an involvement of the town and country planner. There is an involvement of the agricultural sector. There is an involvement of the agri-based industries, where these stakeholders has to be put together in the multi-sectorial approach. And I think last time also we were discussing in ICMR, because we have evidence, we know what is to be done. How to implement is a challenge. So I think NCD is not, it is definitely a preventable, but it requires the behavioral modification. For behavioral modification, you need education, which can be basically promoted through public health approach, the population education activities. And secondly, we need to have an enabling environment to practice healthy lifestyle. You see, if in a Shimla, if you have to walk, except for the Mall Road area, it is very, very difficult to walk. Britishers were much intelligent, I would say, in those days. In a core area, they have the pavements. Today, it is required much more than what was required at that point of time. We do not have that. So I think the Amrit Mission, which is coming up as a smart city program, I think these people, we should also engage those people to give your inputs as to how the town and country planning should be there. And most important thing, the diet is an important, I think, the transition which has taken place. In the diet, we are concerned with the safety of the foods. As you have said, people, the farmers are not consuming the vegetable and fruits because everybody knows they are using a lot of pesticides. How much it is going into the body, is it really, causing more disease rather than preventing certain diseases is in question because we do not have any much data. Data are not being published. So I think it is a very holistic approach. I think I would definitely congratulate Dr. Chauhan, and he is actively involved, and he has basically utilizing his professional knowledge which he has acquired from PJ Chandigarh as a part of MPH training program. I think that kind of people will definitely make a difference in the NCDs also. So with these brief comments, I would like to invite the comments from the audience. We are very senior public health personnel amongst us. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Dr. S.K. Kapoor, who happened to be my teacher during AIIMS, when I was doing graduation. So we have many other senior public health figures. I'm sure their inputs will definitely enrich us, enlighten us in this, to make this conference more successful. Please.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I think all the speakers very nicely presented their topics. And I'm Professor Mansoor from Bangladesh. I am working as advisor in the Department of NCD in Bangladesh University of Health Sciences. Basically, I'm a community medicine professor. Regarding the reduction of 30% tobacco, as Dr. Sohan's presentation, is really a very good achievement. I want to know how. Another to Professor J.S. Thakur, he mentioned about the compliance, low compliance towards NCD prevention and treatment. So what are the causes? How could you do the reduction? And what are the causes of compliance? So I'm asking these questions.
I think, sir, first question, I am more than happy to answer that. That what was the reason behind that, how Himachal could reduce the prevalence of tobacco use? I think what we learned that how to, practice in field and how to focus on, issue-based strategies as per tobacco control is concerned. We started it in 2008. We were having a partner with us, the Himachal Pradesh Voluntary Health Association. And luckily, we have more than 10 partners from Bangladesh also. Mr. Akram is also there, who is working with the union. And we were advised by the union Southeast Asia, New Delhi. We developed the baseline survey. We conducted those surveys that, what is the baseline of tobacco use, other risk factor associated things, and what is the level of enforcement at that time, because the law was in place, but it was in the books. Okay, there was legislation is since 2003 for tobacco control. We tried to implement that legislation in a small jurisdiction in Shimla City. In 2 years' time, we were able to make Shimla City as a smoke-free city. There were certain indicators. It was not that, nobody is going to smoke. There were few jurisdictions that in public places, we should have some boards and signages, something like that. When we succeeded to make Shimla a smoke-free city, after Chandigarh in India, it was the second one. But the first evidence-based, we thought that we can do wonder by implementing the legislation in the entire districts, and we went to the districts. But it took 3 years to declare those district headquarters as smoke-free. But in till 2013, we were able to make Himachal as a smoke-free state as per as the John Hopkins criteria is concerned, because the criteria developed for smoke-free legislation compliance assessment that was developed jointly by Union, PGI Chandigarh, and we people. And after that, John Hopkins adopted that criteria that how to declare a jurisdiction smoke-free. After that, what we did, we took a multiple stakeholder engagement. We involved almost every department, maybe media. We published, I think, 5 papers on that. We have earned media support of more than 3 crore rupees. You cannot believe that. 3 crore rupees se jyada advertisement tobacco ki earned media se aayi hai, jo humne advocacy se liya hai. And the paper is already published. And recently, sir, on detail, we have a joint paper with Professor Thakur. It is, you know, how to implement the empower policies in the low resource settings. Ye abhi, I think it will be coming in the next IGNCD, I think, April ka jo aapka schedule hai, sir. I will be, will be coming in the IGNCD soon. It has been accepted for publication that how to implement the empower policies. But we took everything in account. We could not even imagine that health department can control this tobacco. Education, police department, you know, the excise and taxation, academic institute, Himachal University, the vendors themselves, media, you know, the politicians even. We took the politician to the stage to announce that Rikang Pio is smoke-free. Then it became their commitment. They were very, very agitated, you know, that how to declare Shimla a smoke-free city. Tomorrow, there was a big news. Smoke-free Shimla hua dhuan. That was the real thing. Because after that, DC, SP, we as a state nodal officer, we ran behind the smokers, we went to the shops, that, you know, Shimla is now smoke-free city. This is all about what I wanted to tell you, sir. Next question, I think it is from Professor Thakur about the low compliance, sir.
So the point which to the treatment and the low level of control people for diabetes and hypertension. The reason was lack of access to the essential medicines. And, you know,
called inter-estratification process.
Is also a problem in the distribution system also. For example, in Punjab, you have essential drug list of 230 drugs. And, you know, medicines are there, but they are not procured, right? And there is no requisition from the main store to the centers. So there is a problem of, you know, distribution also, and at the same time, many drugs were not available. Now, one thing which we noticed, you know, there is a big initiative by the name of Resolve, preventing deaths due to cardiovascular diseases. It's a $200 million initiative which has been started recently. And the earlier director of CDC, Mr. Dr. Tom Frieden, is the CEO of the Punjab. 5 states in India are participating. And recently, the Punjab state nodal officer was presenting the data. With 1 year of intervention for access to the hypertension, because hypertension is the focus, the compliance rate, that is the control rate, has increased from 16% to 23% in the state of Punjab. So you can see that, I will say that for in a 1 year period, if your control people are increasing from 26% to 23%, it's a big achievement. And one of their intervention is access to the essential drugs. If you can give drugs for tuberculosis for 6 months when the patient is registered, why can't we ensure the drugs for diabetes, hypertension patient for at least 3 months? And that is possible, and the government has the provision, but there is a lack of administrative bill for implementation of this.
Dr. Gopal, do you have any some figures regarding the what is the compliance rate of, say, for example, antihypertensive treatment in Himachal?
Yes, sir. As far as this data is concerned, sir, whatever output we are getting, sir, it is 23%, sir.
So anything you are trying to take steps or initiatives to improve the compliance rates?
Sir, abhi to we will do evaluation. Ek to kar li hai Professor Thakur ne abhi. We will do that later on. But sir, this is really the gray area. We are saying, on the other hand, that we have, sir, a list of 356 medicines. And the lists are there. We are displaying those lists in the sub-center, you know, in the PSC, that these are the medicines. they should be available there. But you know, practically, the package is not available there. Even in Medical College Shimla, you people are trying to ensure that they should be there. There are big news always. But sir, this needs to be taken care, because abhi grossly we are able to implement the program. But you know, to improve each and every component, hypertension, diabetes, we need to review this.
But you have data of how many patients of hypertension, diabetes are registered in each PSCs?
Yes, sir. I have PSC-wise data, sir. I have village-wise data.
And you have data related to what drugs they are taking? What is the inventory or stock of drugs which is required so that they can indent?
As far as the program is concerned, we have a list of 5-6 drugs, sir. They should be.
Problem वही होती है actually. Yes, sir. I think a patient come with hypertension, PSC after walking maybe 20 kilometers distance from the community.
Yes, sir.
So my suggestion would be that once the patient has been diagnosed to have hypertension, he has been put on certain drugs, why not those medicines can be procured at the sub-center level? You have a gadgets to monitor the blood pressure, and at least they can replenish. Even if they give the treatment, I mean, they repeat the treatment there. Otherwise, they have to come all the way to PSCs to take the medicines, because this is an important barrier of loss of compliance. A disease which is asymptomatic, people need to be really aware of importance of taking the medicines and controlling blood pressure sustainably. Until and unless this kind of awareness comes in the community, it is very difficult to ensure the compliance and control rate.
Sir, got it, sir.
Actually, main problem is that as far as the availability of drugs is concerned, it is the continuity of supply that is more important. Because the moment earlier we used to have almost many of the drugs in IGMC, and people used to come from far off places, we used to give them 1 month, 2 months. They were given, but then suddenly the supply chain was disrupted. Now they are hardly any available, and then people lose faith. They don't come again. Otherwise, people were coming from out of very large areas.
Yes.
As far as smoking is concerned, there is definite fall in the smoked smoke. Because I can say from my experience earlier in our orchard also, people used to have a break after 1 hour, used to do chillum, smoke, cigarette, BD, everything. But now younger generation, they hardly take it. So there is definite, but as far as the on record, as far as this chewed tobacco is concerned, practically you may today claim that there is a total cessation because it is banned. But the hard reality is that in spite of ban, it is available almost every at every place. And those people who are used to it, they are getting it. On paper, it is just sale is banned, so on record, there will not be any sale. But it is an open secret that people are taking it, and it is available.
Yes.
So
yes.
Chewed tobacco is probably not achieved so far in any way. Smoked, agreed. And as far as diabetes was concerned, when I joined services about 35 years back, only diabetes which you used to come across were usually type 1 diabetes.
Yes.
Type 2 were hardly very few. You also are from Karsog. I have also served a lot of there, belong to Karsog area. There were a couple of 2-3 type 1 diabetic, and type 2 diabetic were hardly there. And now the problem is that half of our OPD is diabetic. And Himachal is unfortunately one state where probably after Tamil Nadu, the incidence of diabetes is the highest.
Yes.
And the moment one is diagnosed as diabetic, he has already lost 5 to 7 years of age. They cannot be saved. He will die 5-7 years earlier. But if he takes proper treatment, probably further loss of years can be prevented. And to prevent diabetes, I think we have to go down to schools or maybe at the earliest college level. If the moment when we diagnose a person as diabetic, I think the purpose of diagnosing is defeated, because it is a non-communicable disease which will take claim some few years of the life or disable him at some stage. A diabetes will not die because of diabetes. Your data is showing diabetic non-communicable as death only 2%.
Yes.
Because diabetes as a diabetic ketoacidosis or hypoglycemia will kill only 2%. But I think 2/3 of diabetes will die because of cardiovascular, either MI or stroke. And we are monitoring with Dr. Negi, half of the patients of MI who are admitted in our CCU are diagnosed to have diabetes for the first time. They have a MI, and then we diagnose their blood sugar levels are 300, 400. So they are very, very important. Promotional activity is much more important rather than even diagnosing and then managing them. To manage 130 crore people of diseases, then investigate and treat will be a challenge for any government.
and for any government, it is uncopable.
Sir, thank you very much.
A message from the organizer. We have very short of time. You can, I think, ask during the maybe tea session because she is after us.
We are already late.
Half an hour. We are late. Thank you so much for all the speakers. They have done a wonderful job.
I just take 1 minute. I was requesting for a very long time.
Please, brief.
I just wanted to share this information with this very eminent gathering that in Maharashtra there is a very large movement going on for effortless weight loss by one of our IIPSM persons, Dr. Jagannath Dixit. And thousands of people are joining this movement and people have lost weight. Not only that, because of this, they have experienced reversal of diabetes in many cases, reduction in HbA1c to pre-diabetic levels. And I'm doing an observation study on 1,800 patients. And I would like to invite you to this experience and I'll share the information also. Please give your inputs and I am open to suggestions. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the speaker.
Okay, thank you all. As we come to the close of this session, I would request, I will thank first of all my chairpersons and speakers for this session, and I would request Dr. P.C. Negi to please felicitate Dr. Anand Krishna.
My pleasure.
A big round of applause for him. Sir, near this. This photo guy will come out. Dr. Rajiv Raina, to please felicitate Dr. J.S. Thakur. Dr. Vijay Barwal, please felicitate Dr. Gopal Chauhan. We are very thankful to the speakers. They have come out with very informative session and the chairpersons also for sharing their experiences. And I would like to invite Dr. Kapoor to felicitate Dr. P.C. Negi. Yes, sir. Tabhi, sir, maine tabhi bula.
Guruji ke saath.
Yes, sir. Sir, main aapke mobile pe bhi.
Haan, main mobile pe.
And Dr. J.P. Narayan, please, sir, may I request you to please felicitate Dr. Raina. Group. Sir, please wait for the group photograph of the speakers and the chairpersons and moderator.
You are not giving to Dr. Gopal?
दे दिया सर सर उनके अपने दोस्त से दिलवाया उनके अपने दोस्त से दिलवाया सर वी कैन हैव अ प्लीज वेट फॉर द
फोटोग्राफ मैं इसलिए कह रहा था रेड रेड